Hi everyone. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to log in and get to your free trial class that you signed up for. First off, if you didn't sign up for the free trial class and you're at this video, you can do that by I put the website up here where you can go to computerscienceteachers.com/courses/free-trial-class. If you go there, you can register for an account and log in. Okay, but if you've already done that, you can go to computerscienceteacher.com and just click on my account. And if you get to my account, you'll come down to where it says free trial class, and you'll be able to click on free trial class. You may need to log in first to do that, and you can log in first, and you'll come to our free trial class. So I have an introduction here for classroom and online teachers of how you would use this class if you were using this as a curriculum, a full year curriculum. I know a lot of us right now are just using to kind of fill in the gaps. So you can go through here and look at this if you want to, but this is kind of meant for if you were going to use this as a full year. For homeschool students, if you are looking at this for your homeschool student, I would go and start right here just so that you can know kind of how you would approach this with your homeschool students. What I have in here is a bunch of different units covering different things. So as you look through them, you'll be able to recognize some of the different things that the different topics that we have in AP Computer Science. So I'm just going to click on one of these so that you can see it. So let's look at this one, Lesson 18 on Arrays. You would click on that. Every one of these has some different things. Now, originally when these were set up, this was not meant to be like a you know, we didn't know the coronavirus thing was coming. And so when I set this up, I wasn't thinking of any of that, but just as if you were a classroom teacher, how you would use this with students in your classroom, or if you're an online teacher, how you would use it. But I have a student video that you will walk you through exactly, what you would be covering if you were a teacher. So to kind of give you pointers on how to teach this to your class, if you were just going to teach it straight. So I have, and I also have a student video. This is a student video on YouTube that will walks the student through the lesson for teaching the class. I have some different teaching tips in here. I have the PowerPoint that you can download. I have a project. So for this one is like a boxing simulation project where they're going to build two boxers that box against each other. A set of written exercises, a written quiz, and then I have the answer keys to all of these. Okay. So first off, please, please, please make sure these answer keys don't get out, okay? Don't post these online. Don't give them to your students. Let's keep these protected as teachers as long as we can. Let's do our part just by making sure that we keep these in-house. Don't post them for your students to look at or see. The next videos are going to kind of walk you through how to use each of these things and how you might actually use these for your transition to virtual learning and how I'm going to be using them for my classes. But you have your different topics here. The last ones here, the list interface, array list, those are coming as quick as possible. I will have those on there, you know, hopefully in the next week or so. I know it says March and April. I'm going to try to get those on there quicker and try to get those on in the next week or so. But those are the only things that are kind of missing. But you can look through and you can use these in any way. But I wanted to show you how to access the ones that are here. Everything here is written. You're not going to notice that there's any like multiple choice, interactive where you grade themselves. The reason I've chosen to do this is to prepare our students for the AP exam. I know we have a multiple choice part on the AP exam, but we also have a written part, which is half of it. So my emphasis here has always been, with all my exercises, my quizzes, has been written to get our students comfortable writing, get our students comfortable writing down answers, writing code by hand, because that's what they're going to have to do on the AP exam. I know that the multiple choice parts are on there, but usually I find that if they can write it on the AP exam, I can usually teach them how to do the multiple choice parts later. So all the stuff here is written right now, but I will show you how I actually use those in the videos below, but I wanted to show you how to get access to these and to find the things that you need in the course.